There is a question here that is giving us a curve. A curve is given us y is equal to, look at it, a third x cubed then plus x squared minus, yes, 3x plus 2. So that's the equation of the curve given, plus 2. So a curve is given as y is equal to a third x cubic, that is 3, a third x raised to 3, then plus x squared minus 3x plus 2, minus 3x plus 2. And the question reads, find dy dx. So find dy dx. Very simple. If they ask you to find dy dx, they want you to differentiate the equation of this curve. They want you to get a derivative function of this curve. They want you to get the gradient function of that curve. So how do I get the dy dx? It is very simple. I take the coefficient of x, which is 1 over 3. A coefficient is a value that is just beside the letter, which is now an unknown in an equation of a curve or equation of a straight line. So that means you're going to say the coefficient of x cubic is a third. So I take the coefficient of x, I multiply by the power. I take the power, I multiply by the coefficient of x. Then I'll write x cubic, I reduce the power by 1. Okay, so you say plus, I come back again here, it is plus x squared. So I assume the coefficient of x squared is 1, because just beside this x squared, we have 1. So we're going to say 1, then times 2, the power. So 2 times the coefficient of x, which is 1, because actually x squared. X squared is the same as 1x squared. If someone says x squared is the same as 1x squared, that means I'm going to take 2 times 1. Okay, then I'll write x, then I say raised to 2 minus 1, because during differentiation, we reduce the power by 1. Then I'll come here and say minus, so you have 3x. So I'm going to have, again, x raised to 1, because 3 is the same as x raised to 1, of course, so 3x raised to 1. So I'm going to again have 1 times 3, that gives us 3 times 1, and I'll say x raised to then 1, which is the power by 1. Now we are saying we are differentiating with respect to x. Our constant does not have x. That is now 2. It gets dropped in that case. So finally we shall have our dy dx as a third times 3. This 3 and this 3 will disappear. So we shall have 1x squared. Y squared, 3 minus 1. And I say plus 1 times 2, that is 2. Then we shall have 2 minus 1. That will be just x. Of course, raised to 1. Then minus 3 times 1 is 3. On the other end, we have x raised to 1 minus 1. That gives us 0. So the x is dropped because x raised to 0 is 1. As the way we actually said, that any number raised to 0 is 1. Or any value raised to 0 is 1. So that one can get dropped. So our dy dx is going to be now x squared plus 2x minus 3. And becomes our dy dx. Our dy dx. Correct. Now, you see, as we proceed forward, the question was also actually asking us to get the turning points of the curve. They want us to get the turning points of the curve. And remember, you cannot get the turning points of a curve if you've not gotten the dy dx. Because at the turning point of a curve, let me say, for example, this is my curve. I'm just going to use this one as an example. If this is my curve, this becomes the turning point, and this becomes the turning point. Then at these turning points, the gradient is always zero. You get the point? At the turning points of a curve, the gradient is always zero. When the curve turns, the gradient is zero. When the curve turns, the gradient is zero. So we need first to get the dy dx of that curve for us to get the turning points of this curve, because we know very well at these turning points the gradient function must be equated to zero, because at that point the gradient of that curve will be zero. So first we actually differentiate the equation of the curve to get the dy dx. After we've gotten the dy dx, we equate this dy dx or this gradient function to zero, because at the turning points of the curve the gradient is zero. So we shall proceed. We shall proceed and be able to now solve this equation quadratically. That means we are going to have this. So we have x squared plus 2x, okay, minus 3. X squared plus 2x minus 3. So we will have this. We are going to actually use the sum product or the factorization method. So the sum is 2 and the product is negative 3. We have two numbers. When you add them, you get 2, and you multiply them, you get negative 3. This is a question that came in 2004 in KCSE. That's preferably 2005, that is paper 2. So we have the sum 2 and the product negative 3. So we shall say two numbers when you multiply. Forget about the sum. Focus more on the product. Two numbers when you multiply, you get negative 3. What will be these numbers? You need to say 1 times 3, and the two numbers when you multiply them, you get 3. But you see the product is negative 3. That means one of the numbers must be negative. Why? Because a product between a positive number and a negative number will give you a negative number. So one of these numbers must be negative. And obviously, if the sum is positive, then that means the smaller number must be negative. Correct. So that means negative 1 times 3 is negative 3. Then negative 1 plus 3, the answer must be 2. Negative 1 plus 3, the answer is 2. Okay, let's proceed. We are going now to have x squared, right? Then plus. I want again write 2x. I'll put 2x aside and substitute it with what you call negative 1 and 3 as factors, you see, to consider in this case. So we have plus 3x, because this is positive, we shall say plus 3x, okay, then minus 1x, then we have minus 3 as our constant here. So we'll have x into x plus 3 minus 1. The common divisor of x squared and 3x is x. So x into x squared x, so that x times x is x squared. Then plus x times 3, 3x, minus 1 into x plus 3. Because this and this must be the same. So that's pretty correct. So we shall come here and say x, this one, minus 1. Okay, then we have x plus 3. So we can be able to equate this to 0 and be able to get the values of x. How do we go about it? How do we go about it? We shall say x minus 1 is equals to 0. So x is equals to 0 plus 1. So that our x becomes 1. We shall come here and as well say x plus 3 is equals to 0. So it will be x is equals to 0 minus 3. Then our x becomes negative 3. You see, at the turning point of a curve, you need to get both the values of x and y. We've gotten the values of x in terms of where the curve turns. But now, what would be the corresponding values of y in terms of the turning point of this curve? We'll come here and have this. We'll come here and have this. We shall be able to have this. We shall just say, when x is equal to 1, this value here, what will be the corresponding value of y? So we shall say when x is 1, y will be y is equal to. So I take the value of x, I substitute in the equation of the curve initially given in the question. And the equation of the curve was y, okay, is equals to 1 over 3 x cubic plus x squared minus 3x plus 2. That was the equation of the curve given. So we shall come here and say y will be equal to a third into 1 cubic plus 1 squared minus 3 into 1 plus 2. You substitute the value of x in the initial equation of the curve for you to get the corresponding value of y in terms of where the curve passes. So I'm going to capture those in my calculator and be able to get the answer. So I'll say 1 over 3 into 1 close bracket cubic, then we have plus open brackets 1 close bracket squared, then I say minus 3 into 1 close brackets, then plus 2. So the answer is a third. So the value of y is a third. So that means, in that guess, when x is 1, okay, when x is 1, this one here, the corresponding value of y is a third. So shall say 1 and a third. That is the first turning point of the curve. The first turning point of the curve is x 1 and y a third. The second turning point of the curve will be, we are going to use x as negative 3. So we shall have x is equal to negative 3. So y will be, I'm going to write down the question, a third x cubic plus x squared minus 3x plus 2. So y is equal to a third into negative 3, the value of x cubic plus negative 3 squared. Correct. Then I say minus 3 into negative 3, then plus 2. So it will be the value of y. Let's see. Again, come back to our calculator. Then we are going to have, very good. So we are going to have 1 over 3 into negative 3, close the brackets, raised to 3, plus open bracket negative 3 close bracket squared minus 3 into negative 3 close bracket then plus 2. The answer is 11. So y is 11. So let me just reset the calculator so that it actually comes back to normal. Correct. So we can do that. 1 into negative 3 close the brackets cubic, then plus 3 into, so that is plus open the brackets negative 3 close the brackets squared, then we have minus 3 into minus 3 close the bracket, then plus 2. That gives us negative 7. We can do that so that you can be able to actually be sure of our answer. 1 over 3 open brackets negative 3 close the brackets raised to 3, then plus open brackets negative 3 close the brackets 2, that is raised to 2, minus 3 into minus 3 close the bracket, then plus 2. So answer is 11. Our answer is 11. So in other words, that means when x is negative 3, y is 11. So that's another turning point on the curve. So the first turning point of the curve was 1, the value of x, and a third, the value of y, and negative 3, 11, the value of x and y respectively. So those are the two turning points of the curve in as far as this question is concerned. From this end, you can be able to see what you have actually done. And that means, to summarize this, you want to get the turning points of the curve. First, differentiate the equation of the curve given to get the dy dx, and at the turning points of the curve, the gradient is zero. So you take that gradient function or derivative function equal to zero. Then after that one, we can come and solve it quadratically. We have used what we call the factorization method, where we have gotten the values of x as 1 and negative 3. We take those values and come back to the original equation. We substitute where there's x with 1. First, we get the corresponding value of y as a third. Then come back again and take negative 3 as our x. Then substitute in this original equation, you're going to get the value of y as 11. So the turning points of the curve are 1 and a third and negative 3 and 11. Thank you so much.